business, but on trading across border, there's still a lot of work to be done. We are still about 86 and we need to make ourselves number one on trading across border. Number two, it's not possible to grow without size and scale. When I joined Commerce Secretary as a very young Deputy Secretary, Mr. Abid Hussain, who was then Secretary of Commerce, said that either India should export or perish, but Indians prefer to perish rather than export. And therefore, without size and scale, it's not possible. And size and scale can happen only if we are able to create large-scale economic zones. That's the way it's happened. It happened in Singapore. That's the way it happened in China. Large economic zones were created. Those of you who've seen, and I've seen Suzhou, I've seen Wuxi, all of them are very large infrastructure creation. Infrastructure was created ahead of demand, and they was created right next to the ports, right next to the coast, on coast. So my belief is, rather than special economic zone, India needs coastal economic zones. And India needs to create two very large scale coastal economic zones, create infrastructure ahead of demand there. And Commerce Secretary talked about incentives, and it's running contrary to its commitment to the world WTO, etc. My view is that instead of providing incentives, we should create firstly world-class infrastructure. And secondly, all incentives in this zone should be linked not to exports but to employment. India needs jobs to be created and growth with jobs. And therefore, in this, industries which create 10,000 plus jobs, 10,000 plus jobs, only those industries we need to provide incentives of very high order. And that would fuel growth. So, two coastal economic zones, start with two, create world-class infrastructure and ensure that they are directly linked to the dedicated freight corridor so that goods produced in the northern part of India are reach these ports within 12 to 13 hours. The railways have delayed the execution of dedicated freight corridor. They were to be executed by 2016 end. So I'll request Mr. Agarwal that the entire railway should put its soul and mind to ensure that the dedicated freight corridor should be made fully operational immediately, so that states in the northern part of India, which take 12 to 13 days to put goods on the ports, of India, should be able to put goods in within 12 to 13 hours instead of 12 to 13 days. So I'm a great believer in coastal economic zone. Unless and until we don't import, do value addition and re-export, it will not be possible for India to grow. And importing would mean that we need to bring in lots of ease of doing business. We need to digitize the whole process and ensure that trading across borders is made easy. I've still not been able to figure out why it takes a lot of more time to export rather than import. Imports, we do it in much lesser time. All exports must move out within 24 hours in India, all ports. And therefore, a lot of focus needs to be done on trading across borders. And secondly, create quality infrastructure. And if you are able to create quality infrastructure, you will have the whole world wanting to come to these areas. And thirdly, link this up to employment. If three things we are able to do, then the coastal economic zone will then spiral. It will have a huge demonstration impact, and this demonstration impact will then have a huge impact on India's economy, and exports will then become the key driver of India's exports, and it will be possible for India to produce at globally, to global standards, because you will get size and scale. You will be able to produce at much lower cost. Quite often we say that Indian manufacturing is not competitive. It's not competitive simply because we are not producing to size and scale. And this will happen with coastal economic zone. So instead of special economic zone, I'm a believer in coastal economic zone. I'm a believer in linking it up to employment, and I'm a believer in focusing on making very simple and easy rules and regulations here. And with these few words, I would like to compliment the Commerce Secretary, because this year we are heading for record exports, and I'm sure this trend of record exports would... And this has been achieved under his stewardship as Commerce Secretary, and I'm quite sure that next year he'll achieve another 20% additional growth because of agriculture exports and provide greater jobs for our farmers. So,
Myanmar.